Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to use smart objects with your Quill graphics. So more specifically, how to change this kind of image to whatever image you want. So we're going to use this this quote right here. Just open it in Photoshop. And so now you will see this icon right here. That means this is a smart object. And once you double click it, it will load an image itself, and you can see this one is more in this blue color, so it's modified in some way, and it's a very simple way to load this image. Once you load this image, it will automatically be put right here in the nice formatting, nice colors and all that. It will be all done for you, so all you have to do is just upload the image right here. So go now to the publicdomainpictures.net. That's a great website to find public domain images. And let's just look for one image that we can use. Let's see this one. Yeah, this one is good. So let's just open it up and copy. Go back and click save. Paste. Control V on your keyboard. And then we can move. You can see the layer on the right. Press. Move to right here, and we can move this layer however we want. It's a bit big, so let's make it smaller. So press Ctrl T on your keyboard. Let's maybe it 50%. Click this for the proportional scaling. Then we can move it. Let's maybe do it right here. Click OK. And now, in order to this image to be loaded right here, all you have to do is just press Save. So I will do Control S or File Save. Once you do that, once we go right here, you can see the image is loaded. You can see the image is different. Now, if you want to edit it a bit more, so for example, this image may not look the best for the blue color right here. It may look better with the orange or yellow. We can change the color of the full background. By going right here, rectangular one, you can see right here, and we can change the color. So we can now do something more like this, for example. I think that would look better. Oh, this one's really good, for example. And you can see, it looks very interesting. So that's really how you can load any kind of images by just double clicking and loading your image, clicking save, and that's pretty much it. And that allows you a lot of flexibility in your quotes to really customize them however you want. Okay, thank you so much for watching.